last 3-4 days, I have seen your very active participation and your excitement regarding this science exhibition. We all really feel very good when we see your such type of participations. I must say that the effort which you students are putting for this exhibition is really praiseworthy.
Today is a proud moment that on 26 and 28 we have organized science competition, science exhibition competition for class 9th and 10th. Our sir as well as our teacher, they have cooperated well along with the student who have done a marvelous work for making the program successful. I am thankful to all my colleagues, principal sir for guiding and especially to Ashish Manishandilya who have organized this work.
On the occasion of Science Day, and I also want to congratulate to all the science teachers, principal sir, coordinators, and making successful Science Day celebration in our DBB. Thank you.
We know that 28 February is celebrated as Science Day. इस डे को हम लोग सीवी रमन डे के नाम से भी जानते हैं. आज 28 फरवरी को हमारे स्कूल में साइंस एग्जीबिशन डे भी सेलिब्रेट किया जा रहा है, जहाँ पे बच्चे अपने अपने एफर्ट्स को लगा करके कई सारे ऐसे इनोवेटिव टेक्निक को डेवलप कर रहे हैं जो हमारे समाज के लिए, हमारे देश के लिए काफी ज्यादा महत्वपूर्ण साबित होगा.
साइंस एग्जीबिशन ऑन 28 फरवरी एंड द ओकेजन ऑफ साइंस डे, स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9th एंड 10th has been prepared science exhibition many activities.
First of all, I'm thankful to our principal sir who has given us opportunity to celebrate science exhibition in our school. Students are very enthusiastic, they are doing very well, they are using so many creations and giving maximum output. They are using waste materials to give the best of whatever the projects they are making. I've seen so many projects in 9th class, 10th class.
Principal, my colleagues and my lovable students, I firstly would like to convey my cordial thanks to all the participants of this science exhibition. Really your efforts are admirable, fantastic and praiseworthy. I heartily appreciate your wonderful and creative skills you all have endeavored for here today.
Hello sir, my name is Sanskar Mishra and I am from class 9th. Here my project is hydroponics indoor gardening without soil. Commercial agriculture mein hydroponics use ko promote kiya Berkeley ke ek scientist William Gehring ne. उन्होंने एक्चुअली इसका नाम एक्वाकल्चर रखा था, लेकिन जब उन्होंने पता चला कि एक्वेटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म की स्टडी को एक्वाकल्चर कहते हैं, तब उन्होंने इसे एक नया नाम दिया और वो था हाइड्रोपोनिक्स, जिसे आज तक हम लोग यूज करते हुए आ रहे हैं. इसमें लेस जगह में हम लोग ज्यादा से ज्यादा फार्मिंग कर सकते हैं. हाइड्रोपोनिक्स के बहुत सारे बेनिफिट्स हैं. पहली बात, वो सेम वाटर को यूज करता है, तो एक्चुअली एक फैक्ट है कि नॉर्मल एग्रीकल्चर में जितना वाटर यूज होता है, हाइड्रोपोनिक्स में उसका सिर्फ 10% यूज होता है. ऑल्सो इसमें सॉइल नहीं लगती, इंसेक्टिसाइड्स पेस्टिसाइड कुछ नहीं लगते, सो इट्स एनवायरमेंटली फ्रेंडली एज वेल एज. शहरों में जहाँ जगह कम होती है, दिस इज अ परफेक्ट सोल्यूशन एंड दिस लुक्स सो ब्यूटीफुल ऑल्सो, एंड इट कैन बी यूज सच प्लेसेस लाइक वाटर स्कार्सिटी प्लेसेस. They can be used and it can help a lot of people who are suffering by water scarcity problem. Thank you.
First of all, thank you principal sir and all teachers to give us this golden opportunity to participate in this science exhibition. Our project is JCB. The full form of JCB is Joseph Carroll Bamford. It was discovered by Joseph Bamford. It works on the hydraulic pressure. Which hydraulic pressure is the pressure that is exerted by the flow of the liquid. Actually, it is not a pressure. It is just the flow of the liquid. But when the liquid flows, the resistance in the part of the liquid exerts the pressure, which causes the hydraulic pressure. It works on the Pascal's law.
Myself Shruti Aswal and this is my team Anshal Kumari, Shamya Shah, Khushi Travi and Nikke Singh. First would like to extend our thanks to our principal sir and science teacher for giving us wonderful opportunity to showcase our innovative skill. We work on a project sustainable development. Sustainable development means using resources in a limited amount and also conserving it for for our future generation. Doing it, it will end soon. So here we are generating electricity using a solar panel which is transported to the hospital, and here we are generating electricity using windmill which is transported to the factory.
We are the student of the hospital with the fit of class 9, and we are very happy to got an opportunity to make something about science. We are very thankful to our principal sir who gave this opportunity. We are very thankful to our science teacher, even Tiwari sir and assist sir who helped us a lot. After all, our project is EarthGate alarm, which is very helpful in future and in present also. Either we win or loss in this present, it doesn't matter. The matter is what we should learn from this project.
Myself, Avinash, from last 10 to hospital with the fit. This is our team, Alok Gupta and Daniel Prakash. We admit this is the point, which the aim of this project is to transfer electricity by RSA.
It is for work with the principle of electromagnetic induction. According to which, when a conductor is placed inside a varying magnetic field, it experiences an induced currents. That is the same.
Firstly, I would like to thank Mr. P.C. Srivastava, our principal sir, who have given us golden opportunity to participate in the science exhibition. Our project is a working robot. Robot can do multiple tasks at a time without any distraction. For example, cleaning house, washing clothes.
Hello, I am Arun. Wishing a very good morning to all of you. I am Aditya Pandey from Class 10 DVP. I am going to represent this project with my all group members. Here, we designed a wireless electrical device. We use a simple remote, an IR receiver and a transmitter, and a receiver placed on the side of circuit. From this remote, we can on up the lights and change the color also of this light with this remote. The main task of this project is the rod that is also controlled by remote control device.
And we are the students of Class 10 G1 of Devasli Vidyapeeth.
We are very thankful to our principal sir and assist sir to give us opportunity to take part in this science exhibition.
Our project is on the topic Smart City.
Also, we call Smart City as the future city.
Basically, in present time, the electricity is generated through water and coal energy, which is in very limited amount. But in future time, we can use the solar energy and wind energy to generate electrical energy, which is a non-renewable resource.
I am the student of the Devasli Vidyapeeth. My name is Sakshi. Today I will try to show the work of the detector. Through this, we can also irrigate the fields and also generate the electricity.
Alright. Good morning, my science teachers, principal sir, and my all dear friends. We are the students of the Devasli Vidyapeeth and the students of Class 10. In this project, we have made various things. Firstly, we have made an earthquake alarm in which we have connected the wire to a battery. When the safety pin is touched to the wire, it produces a ringing sound.
It takes sound that alarm,
which works as demonstrated by him. And a street light, which when connected to battery, all street light glows. They all are connected in a series combination. And lastly, we had made a room heater in which the bulbs are connected, bulbs of 100 watts are connected in parallel combination.
Hello everybody, my name is Sumit Gupta and this is my team. We had made a laser security alarm with our great efforts of at least 2 days. We had just made it for some security of our houses. We had done a good trial on this at a big stage in our houses, which is very effective. We had made it for using it in schools, hospitals and such places which are very inside this. We made on a big stage, but at this small demo piece, if somebody enter, then it start beeping. You can see that while it start beeping, it get stopped when somebody goes.
We have created our project of clamping switch, which basically works on the clamping which turns off any electrical appliances only with clapping. So in now,
good morning all of you. Our project is Smart Village. We show all the things that needs village. We show in this project.
was a cattle shed that's where the all animals are living their cattle shed, and we provide a drip irrigation where that we provide a cultivation in a smart way, and a biogas which is used for every fuel in every houses.
Myself Sumit Rohit from class 9C and my classmate Aditya Singh, we work on a project of the steam engine which when you put a candle inside the water, they convert water is in oil and water is passes through it and they are forward and return to the shop, and they work on the principle of thermodynamics.
Hello everyone, myself Nilesh Kishwa from Class 10 DTFTV. I would like to thank my principal sir and honorable science teacher Ashish sir for giving me golden opportunity to participate in science exhibition. I have worked on the project Life for Transmission via light, and Wi-Fi uses radio signals for data transmission and Wi-Fi uses light for data transmission. I think put this closer to this, the data transferring will be and when we put this back, as light intensity decreases, the data transfer speed decreases. And when it comes closer, then light transferring speed increases. The advantages of Wi-Fi are speed, security, and fairness. Another drawback is that when anything comes in between the light, the data transmission will be stopped.
It is based on double dispersion reaction. Calcium carbonate react with oxygen, react with water, and form acetylene gas and calcium hydroxide.
Visual and audio pattern is IOC. Smart street lights. If anyone comes in front of this infrared sensor, then it will automatically turn on the lights, and when they pass away from there, it will automatically
fire alarm. It make a beep sound.
Our third project is related to an smart traffic light. So here we have an Arduino Uno board which act as a brain and control all its function related to its traffic lights. And not only this, it can also control the street lights. And here is another thing is there, as you can see, this is a Bluetooth module which enables us to communicate with this project with the help via the smartphone. Yeah, now it's connected. So it can control via the voice control, or we can type the command right there, terminal. It can work on the basis of I enter the code street on, then the street lights will show in their output.
Good afternoon everyone, myself Srishti Yadav from class 9G1. In this model I have to show what is pollution, what is causes of pollution and how to prevent them. I am heartily thankful to our principal sir and all the teachers and also my parents who give me financial support and also moral support.
Good afternoon everyone, my name is Akash Pandey and we have made an artillery type cannon. So this project has two parts, one body and second the working model. The body is made up of thermocol and the working model is made up of PVC element. The elements are 2 inch diameter 1 foot pipe and 4 inch diameter 1 foot pipe. We have used a 4 inch cap and a 2 into 4 converter. So we put it all together with the help of a solvent to make pressure in it. So when we burnt it, it makes pressure and whatever we put in it comes out. Thank you principal sir, thanks to our teacher who gave us opportunity to do all that. Thank you.
Being a student of the Devastri Vidyapeeth, myself Anushka Srivastava from class 10th Z1, thanks to our principal sir and science teacher to give a golden opportunity to hemodialysis. First of all, what is hemodialysis? Hemo means blood, or dialysis means to filter blood.
My project name is Hologram 3D project. It is invented in British by physician Dennis Gabor in 1971 who awarded for Nobel Prize. And hologram is a technology which is best for generating three-dimensional image.
Good morning to all of my dear friends and respected teachers. It's the automatic street light which conserves the electricity and saves the electricity. On the night time, when the dark is on, then it will already automatically glow, and at the daytime it will be closed.